have guests in the studio this morning, and I'm always happy to have on the show Carol Sexton with the Pulaski County Public Library and Lindsay Mee, your first time on the show, also from the library. So good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having us.
It's always good to have you here because I love talking about the Pulaski County Public Library and all of the amazing things you all do and the programs that you have there. So Carol, let's just start talking about summer at the library.
Great. We begin June 6th. It's a Saturday due to the fact that our schools get out a tad later than normal. Last day of school for Pulaski County is June 3rd, and Somerset gets out before that, and Somerset Christian and Science Hill is about the same time. So we begin Saturday, June 6th, with Truck and Vehicle Day. Yay! And inflatables from Jumping Jacks and face painting and bubbles and a movie. So much fun.
Your big kickoff to summertime.
It's the big one, yes.
At the library. What do you have coming up immediately for kids and teenagers at the library?
We have lots of things we're offering right now. Now, tomorrow at the library is our last literacy bell ringing with the Pulaski County Schools. 8 elementary schools will be there. Tomorrow afternoon we have Color Outside the Lines free art classes with Lakia Stout. And she is sponsored by Watershed Arts Alliance and Applied Behavioral Advancements. And they do free art classes for teens and children between the ages of 5 and 12 and then 13 to 19.
And all of the events that you have at the library for kids in the summertime are free.
Absolutely. When we go out to talk to the schools, and we're making our tours right now, and that's one of the reasons why we're here with you, is we tell them it's all free. We'll feed your brain. We will have fun, it's free, and we will also feed lunch to these children at all of our programs.
Lindsay, you take care of the bookmobile. Most people love the bookmobile. Talk about the rounds that the bookmobile will be taking this summer, where you will be, and where you're going.
Okay, well, I am very privileged to be part of an outreach program within the library that allows us to reach out to a lot of places that may not be able to come to the library. We do go to visit 3 different stops, and we start in Burnside and then at a wonderful place, Cumberland Manor, and those children there. Then we go to Hopeway, and then finally we finish up our day in Colonial Village. So it's a wonderful time. We kind of do a smaller version of what Miss Carol does in the library at these stops. We have programs and prizes and snacks, and it's a lot of fun. Last year we had a lot of kids that I had never met before, which was really fun and interesting. And, you know, over the course of the summer, because we do visit them 5 times a week, we do get to develop kind of a friendship with these kids, and they look forward to seeing us, and, you know, we look forward to seeing them, and, you know, you kind of get in a wonderful place where, you know, you probably wouldn't normally, because we get to see them every single day. So it's nice to see how they progress in reading and things like that over the summer.
I remember the bookmobile coming to school when I was in elementary school. It was like my version of the ice cream truck. I loved the bookmobile. And coming up on May the 12th, Ms. Carol, you have Lego Mania.
What's
Lego Mania?
We now are the proud owners of 3 huge tubs of Legos. I mean, sometimes we would give them a task and say you have 80 pieces to make something, maybe we give them a theme. But we have found that if we just put those Legos out, they will come. So recently, Jason at Little Monster Comics donated a huge, huge tub full of Legos with a lot of Star Wars characters in it.
So we allow them
to just be. We'll give them snacks. We will just put the Legos out and let them create. We'll take pictures of them. So we try to do that once a month. But during, say, spring break, we've had them out every day. There were adults who sat down with them. Legos are never going to go out of style.
I'm so glad for that.
Yes.
Legos are wonderful. What is the summer schedule at the library? When do you open? When do you close, so that people can know when they can come to these events?
We are starting on Saturday, June 6th, and we will do organized programs strictly for summer reading through the whole month of June. And this includes our branch libraries, Lindsay and the Bookmobile, our teen program, and adults. And this will take place literally every day of June, beginning June 6th, morning, noon, sometimes evening, and Saturdays. So there is something for everyone on our summer reading schedule.
You also have your summer schedule at the library on your website.
We do.
All of the events that are taking place, what time they are. So if you want a complete list of what's happening at the library this summer, you can visit PulaskiPublicLibrary.org.
Yes.
And keep up to date with what's going on.
Right.
Lindsay, coming up on June the 20th, it's Cook Like a Superhero, and you mentioned that's for the tweens.
Absolutely. It's going to be a lot of fun, and the tweens are a very wonderful group of people that sometimes get overlooked, and we never wanted that to happen in our library. So Miss Carol developed this wonderful program that's specifically designed with them in mind. That awkward area where you're not really, you know, a child, where, you know, some of the things may not appeal to you and you're not quite yet a teen, but so you're somewhere in between, which is a wonderful place to be. But there is a lot of programs that are just for that specific one, like the cooking, like the egg drop, all those fun things. And I love cooking. I don't necessarily love the mess that comes with it, but and I think the kids like that they created something from start to finish.
And it's Cook Like a Superhero.
Absolutely.
And that is June the 20th. Miss Carol, you mentioned the Literacy Bell earlier.
Mm-hmm.
That is a wonderful program
it
that you all
is.
Have at the library. And I'm very proud that the Somerset Noon Rotary Club
yes.
is now working with you and with the Literacy Bell
yes.
program. Talk a little bit about the program and how Rotary is helping you facilitate that.
We'll do. When we built our new library, we wanted some way to recognize and engage our community, and especially those young readers, that awakening that happens when you can read. And the words on the page become sentences, and those sentences become paragraphs, and then it becomes a story. And so there was a family who donated in memory and honor of their mother, the Hoffmans, to recognize, you know, she was a strong believer in literacy and its possibilities, where the places it can take you, which are everywhere. You can go anywhere. So we do lunches, celebrations that recognize early readers from all the school systems in our community and homeschoolers. And so the Noon Rotary has stepped up to sponsor that this year, and we are so grateful. We feed them lunch, we give them a bag, we give them a program and a certificate with their name on it that recognizes this very important day in their lives. And we do bookmarks, and it becomes just, as we said, a celebration. And we're so happy that Noon Rotary, we literally cannot do without them. I mean, it has been wonderful and very humbling.
We've talked about the Literacy Bell program before
yes.
when you've been on the show. And any parent who has a child that becomes an independent reader for the first time can
mm-hmm.
bring their child to the library
yes.
and participate in ringing the Literacy Bell.
Absolutely.
They don't have to be in a school setting.
Absolutely. We recently had a group of parents who may have missed the celebration and brought their children back that evening to ring it because they said, I don't want to miss this. So absolutely. We had a young girl, Liberty, who is 4, who rang it couple of weeks ago. So we may have grandparents.
Liberty rang the bell.
She did. That sounds fabulous.
And she was also our first child to complete the 1,000 books before
yeah.
kindergarten.
Yeah. And she was wonderful. They don't have to read to us when they come. We believe that they can read because you have told us that. And I've never had a child say, I can't read, Miss Carol. They're just, you know,
Mom just made me come.
Yes. No, but they are genuinely touched by this. When they hear that bell ring, their smiles are priceless. And it just makes the community aware. Why is that bell ringing? Because you can hear it in downtown Somerset, Lexington to Knoxville, too. So people know that something magical is going on in the life of a child.
We have much more to talk about when it comes to summer at the Pulaski County Public Library. We're talking with Carol Sexton and Lindsay Mead, and we will be right back on Mid-Mornings with Amy, presented by the Mohole of Somerset. Welcome back to Mid-Mornings with Amy. It is Wednesday, April the 6th, 8:47 in the morning, and we are talking with Carol Sexton and Lindsay Mead with the Pulaski County Public Library. And it's summertime at the library, which means lots of activities going on that are free
yes.
to families, for all the kids, all the tweens, all the teenagers, and even adults. Let's talk about, Miss Carol, superheroes at the library.
Ooh.
You're focusing on superheroes this summer.
Our theme is Every Hero Has a Story. And literally, everyone is and can be a hero. We are visiting God's Food Pantry, one of the most wonderful places in our county that serves people who are in need. We're having all types of programs around that theme. We're having Captain America, Batman, and Spider-Man in June. And last year we probably had 600 to 800 children and their caregivers come. John Berlew may have been one of those who came, I don't know. And he's a little bit of a fiend for superheroes. But it'll be Tuesday, June 16th, and they will be at the library from 11 until 1. And we will hopefully have all kinds of young superheroes to visit these superheroes. And one of the things that we're doing is we're asking you to identify a hero in your life. We're asking the children to do that. And it may be their mother, or it could be that they idolize a fireman. Whoever it is that they think is a hero, we're asking them to share that with us. And that's how they will get their T-shirts, among other things that we have that we're giving out.
And you brought a T-shirt in this morning, and they're really cool.
I like
them. So I think all the kids will love the T-shirts. Coming up on May the 28th at 6 p.m., you have the American Girl Program.
We do. And we actually do that monthly, the fourth Thursday of each month at 6 p.m. No doll ever needed to attend. But by the way, we have Molly that you can check out from the library with all her accessories and her book and a diary that goes home with her that you tell about what you and Molly did while you have her checked out.
So just like the kids can check out books, they can actually check out an American Girl doll and take home.
Absolutely. She's in her own suitcase. Cool. But we do, we center on a different American Girl, read a little bit from the book, do the food from that book, and have a craft related to the time of that American Girl.
Lindsay, let's talk about the federal summer feeding program that the library is instrumental in.
Oh, we are definitely, it's a wonderful opportunity to help people who may not have that meal that they would have normally in school, the children who may not have that meal. And it is a wonderful program. And the library has been a part of it for as long as I can remember being part of the library. I think 9, 10 years, somewhere in there. We go to Pulaski County High School every morning, pick up the lunches, and then we have them. And then after the program, just like we fed their mind and all that, we also feed them. And anyone under 18 can receive this lunch as, you know, when they come to the school or to the library, excuse me. And they, with that, it's just a wonderful opportunity for them, you know, to come and have this wonderful program and not have to worry about, you know, grabbing something to eat on your way in or on your way out. And they're all very healthy meals, and the kids like them. And we also, those are the meals that we also take out when we do outreach.
And that is important for us to remember, that a lot of kids count on lunch, breakfast at school.
Absolutely.
And of course, when school is not in session, then they need food for the summer as well.
We do live in a community that is in great need that I don't think we always realize. But yes, we do, and it is a wonderful way to help offset that need.
If anyone listening might know of a family with children who needs to be a part of this program this summer, how can they get in touch with you to be on the list of families to receive?
Well, all they have to do is come to the library. You know, even if they don't come to one of our summer reading programs, they will receive a lunch for those children. And one of the ways we get the word out is through all the different, when we go out to schools and we drop these off at the health department, the brochures, and local pediatrician's office, and we go to interagency and let all those other agencies know, nonprofit agencies knows that we are here, and we talk to the mayor of Somerset, and can't say enough about Mr. Butcher and the great Pulaski County School System, which sponsors it. If they didn't sponsor it, we would not have it. So thank you.
Literally a community effort to feed the kids.
Absolutely.
In the summertime. The Pulaski County Public Library has several branches. So if people live in the city limits of Somerset, where can they go?
It's one of the questions I ask. It's a question for a prize. We have branches north, south, east, and west. Somerset, our main branch, is right in the middle. We have Science Hill, has a lovely branch in downtown Science Hill. Nancy, which is right in the shopping center where the dollar store is, and that is right at the crossroads before you get to the Y where you go to Nancy Elementary. Burnside has a beautiful branch, and as does Shotville. So located in areas of our county, then Lindsay picks up the rest.
Let's talk one more time about the bookmobile, Lindsay,
yes,
because
ma'am.
That's what you do.
Yes, ma'am. I absolutely, it's an honor to drive the bookmobile, and I never realized what an honor that was, but the state of Kentucky is the largest bookmobile serving state.
Really?
So we have the most bookmobiles per capita in
Kentucky.
In the United States, the Kentucky, yeah. Absolutely. But it is a wonderful opportunity. You meet a lot of interesting people. I tell people all the time, one of my favorite jobs is I get to go to the daycares and the preschools and things like that and watch them check out a book. And I love their reaction when they first step on. It's quite amazing. They just, oh my goodness, it's a library on wheels. You know,
that's and it's kinda, so colorful. You can't
yes.
miss it.
Yes.
That was a great Kirby Stevens and Company designed the logo for the bookmobile, and Lindsay is one of a few in a long line of great bookmobiles. I mean, there's Babe Hughes, and then we had several other people, but they're, you know, pack mule librarians. I mean, that's where it started out, with the New Deal to create jobs, and they would travel through the mountains and hills of eastern Kentucky and spend the night with their patrons and eat dinner with them. And it was, I mean, how wonderful is that history?
Can there be a passenger in the bookmobile?
There can be.
I would love to ride along with you sometime.
Absolutely. I don't know how you would feel about that, but you should
I've
come
never
on.
Ridden in a bookmobile, and it's been a long time since I've been in a bookmobile.
You should it's come out with her once.
So we'll coordinate our schedules, and absolutely. I would love to ride along with you
absolutely.
In the bookmobile.
So tell our insurance company.
I'll sign anything you want, I promise. And once again, the Pulaski County Public Library has a great website, so that if you want to follow what's happening at the library, you can visit PulaskiPublicLibrary.org. We're talking with Carol Sexton and Lindsay Mead, and we will be right back. Thank you for joining me this morning on Mid-Mornings with Amy. It is Wednesday, April the 6th, and always a great time when we're talking about what all is happening at the Pulaski County Public Library. Carol, Lindsay, thank you for being here this morning. We're already making plans to do a ride-along in the bookmobile, maybe a live broadcast from the bookmobile. Very exciting. Let's talk about Imagination Library in the few seconds we have left.
Wow. We have over 1,000 children registered for our Dolly Parton Imagination Library, thanks to the generosity of many, many supporters and sponsors. Books in the hands of children from birth to age 5. We know that children who have books in their home are more likely to pick them up and be engaged with a caregiver. They receive a book once a month. It costs $25 a year to sponsor a child.
Thank you all so much. Please take your kids to the library this summer and visit PulaskiPublicLibrary.org.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.